Park Circle, Lubbock Circle, is Broadway and 8th Avenue. Sorry, I forgot that wasn't up there, sir.
Mush.
We were waiting for you. That will be the... We do have another stair, but that one will have an elevator that I'm pretty sure. Alright. So, the elevated rail line, very popular in the 30s, the 40s, and into the 50s.
Is that it? Is that my picture with her? Video banana.
We get the food out, we get them into an iced environment so that everything doesn't rot.
Yes.
When they constructed this back in the 1980s, storage unit, there had been so much ice that had been built up on the walls, they had to take 7 months to defrost the entire building before they could actually cut the windows that are on there now. There's going to be two things that are going to be the death knell of the elevated rail line. One is going to be refrigeration. Once people have refrigerators at home, you could have all sorts of supermarkets all around the city. You don't need one concentrated area like the meat packing district where people have to come on an almost daily basis to pick up their food stuff. The other is going to be in shipping transportation. Behind me, you'll see the pylons where all of them, where one of those docks is. So they had to work the docks. But after World War II, container shipping becomes the preferred way for people to transatlantic and transatlantic trade. You've never seen one of these container ships. They're my belt. They're huge. I need lots of backspace for these gaps and cranes. Pick up one of the containers, put it on the back of an 18-wheeler, send it out into our emerging interstate highway. New York City is not well integrated into America's interstate highway system. And here in Manhattan specifically, we don't have the backspace for these huge gantry cranes to store all the unused container ships. So what happens is that these companies like Nabisco, they pull up stakes, abandon all of those working docks that used to be here, and they stop using the trains because they move to other places in the United States or even other places in the world. The last train to run on the elevated rail line was 1980. It was carrying frozen turkeys around Thanksgiving time. New Yorkers were very nostalgic about going to the meatpacking district to get their Thanksgiving turkeys. And then after that, Conrail decided to do was just to board this up and abandon it. What happens is that right off the winds from the Hudson River, it starts to resort back to the natural sort of wild weeds and wildflowers that used to be here. And in one sense, it was really beautiful because in the middle of the asphalt jungle that New York City is, you had just had this almost like a prairie that was just elevated above all of here. But it was also really dangerous. If you watch a lot of early CSI, they'll be like, we found another dead body on the Highline. Now, when I was a kid,